What's going on YouTube? Today's video, I'm going to be making a jump cue. I ordered these cue blanks from Schmelke. This is what I ordered. I ordered two shafts and one handle. I already turned one of the Purple Heart shaft into a made one. This is going to my Jacobi. This is with the G10 tip and of course the joint itself. So let's go ahead, check this Purple Heart out. We're going to go ahead and do the weight. And the weight of the blank shaft weighs 5.75 ounces. The jump handle itself, it weighs 4.2 ounces, and the finished shaft weighs 4.5 ounces. So let's go ahead and take the measurements of these shafts. So this is the shaft itself on the back side, and this is 0.96. We'll do the front. And that is about 0.55. So I'm gonna be turning those and making it into a playable shaft. This is the handle itself. This is where the joint would go. This is 0.88. And the back side is 1.1314. So I'm gonna be turning these with the help of the Mid-American Q-Lay. I ordered some stuff also. As you can see, this is what I got. I ordered a router mount. This is, I also bought the router, of course. I already used it. This is what's gonna help me turn those cues. And of course, another post stand. I ordered an extra one. And the most important to me, I think, is another tailstock, because I already set this tailstock, and I'm gonna be doing that on the videos where I use set a taper so the router will just go straight and you'll have a taper on the joints. For the jump cue, this is what I'm gonna be installing. I ordered a aluminum radial pin. This is the weight for the pin itself. It weighs 0.5 ounces. And of course I got a G10 tip ferrule combined, and I'm gonna be putting black joints. I'm gonna be doing a quarter inch on the joints itself and trying to make that as flush as possible. Before I work on the shaft, I wanna go ahead and show you how the shaft came. So we're gonna go ahead and roll it on the side, and you can see the taper. And this is the finished taper, so it's gonna be hard for me to remove some of the taper, but it's not really straight. And if you roll it on the table itself, you can see how it wobbles. Hopefully the router can get some of that out, but I can only do so much on the router because you don't want to change the taper, the pro taper on this. First, I'm gonna go ahead and work on the handle. I'm gonna go ahead and install the radial pin and set this up on the lathe. Here's the finished product. This is a jump cue with all purple heart with the aluminum radial pin and a G10 ferrule with the tip combined. So it's a full G10 itself. And I'm gonna go ahead and measure all the size of the collars and the joint itself. First, we're gonna go roll it and look at how it rolls. So that's just the shaft itself. And we'll roll it this way. And then you'll see it when it's combined. So it's pretty straight. And you'll see it this way. So this is the finished product. This is what I also did with the bumper. I did a step on it, meaning you can see inside where I drilled it, then I put a step. So that bumper, half of the outside goes inside. It doesn't stick out just like that. I didn't like that look, so I wanted more of a flush look. So it looks cleaner. And of course I did a little nub here, so you can hold it here, and it came with this, where it's already sanded, and then you can use it for your dart stroke. So let's go ahead and weigh every single part, and we'll do some jump shots. Before I weigh the cue, let's go check the length of the cue itself. So this is the shaft itself. As you can see, it's right over 30 inches. It's about 30 inches and a quarter. And this is the handle. It's over 12 inches. With the pin itself, it's about 13 and a half. So with the cue together, this should be over 40 inches. The total length is about 42 and a half inches long. So let's go ahead and start off the weight of the shaft. This is the shaft itself. And the final weight is 5 ounces. And this is the handle itself. And it weighs 4 ounces. And it should be 9 ounces when it comes together. 9.05 ounces. So we're gonna go ahead and measure the collars. So I made this at 840. So they're at 0.840, and I got the tip. This should measure at 13.5. So now let's go ahead and test it, because biggest thing is you can make it, but if does it really perform? That's the biggest question. So now let's go ahead and test out this jump cue. I got the cue ball and object ball about a diamond away, so all I'm gonna do is jump over the object ball and try to get the cue ball into the pocket. So it jumps. Now we're gonna go ahead and test out the dart stroke. For this jump, I got the bridge out and the cue ball and object ball is about a diamond apart. Hopefully I can get this cue ball into the corner pocket. So let's do a closer jump where the cue ball and object ball is about a ball's width apart. So this is going to be a dart stroke. The cue ball should go into the side pocket. Thank you for watching this video of me making this cue and testing it out. I'm gonna be giving this cue away once I hit the 3,000 subscribers. One lucky winner will win this cue. So if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. Also, hit that like button and leave a comment below. Thank you for watching and see you next time.
Thank you for watching. Please subscribe me. Don't forget the thumbs up. Bye bye.